Hello, welcome back. If you're looking for inspiration as an artist, then the work of Shakespeare is a pretty good place to start, and that's exactly what the singer Rufus Wainwright has done for his latest album.
He's taken the Bard's famous sonnets and turned them into songs. He's also enlisted some A-list help along the way. The likes of Carrie Fisher and William Shatner have both been involved.
We'll talk to Rufus in a moment. Morning to you, lovely to see you.
Good morning.
First of all, we're going to look at the video of his favourite song from the album.
A woman's face with nature's own hand painted.
Feels out that,
morning.
Isn't it?
Yeah, it's a good morning track, for
oh,
sure.
Oh, it's lovely to see you. Oh, just tell us a little bit about the inspiration, because it's a kind of, it's an odd mixture, not an odd mixture, an eclectic mixture.
Yeah, well, in pure Shakespearean fashion, I never planned to do this, and it just sort of all happened naturally. About 8 or 9 years ago, I did a production of the sonnets in Berlin, actually, with Robert Wilson, the great American director. And so I had, 10 or 12 songs that I'd written for this production, and then I ended up performing them here and there myself, and people really reacted well to them and seemed to, it had some sort of effect, and people kept asking, and then, lo and behold, it's the 400th anniversary of his death. Why we're celebrating that? Interesting.
Well,
it's also his birthday, right? It's also his birthday.
Because the words still
have
meaning.
Yeah, I just meant celebrating someone's death.
Yes.
It's weird.
We know what you
there's
mean.
A lot of other dead people I'd like to celebrate who should die. So the 400th anniversary came up, and I had all these tracks, and it just made sense to do an album surrounding them, thanks to Deutsche Grammophon.
And it's interesting, it's taken quite a bit of time to get together, because Louise said it's an eclectic mix. It's classical, it's non-classical, it's spoken word as well. So how much have you sort of poured into it in terms of time and effort?
It's literally 50-50 classical pop, and the reason... And I did it with the BBC Symphony Orchestra, so thank you. and that's a very unusual combination. In fact, I'm not sure it's been done before that you've had a record that's totally half and half, both genres. So.
And it's not just that, is it? Because you've got actors as well on it.
Yes, recitations.
Tell us a little bit about the actors.
Yes, well, there's Carrie Fisher, my dear friend Carrie, and there's William Shatner, fellow Canadian... freak, and you'll love it when I say that, and also there's Helena Bonham Carter, and also Sean Phillips, a great English, or I should say Welsh actress.
And did you contact them, or how did it work?
Well, the other person who's on it that everybody's very excited about is Florence Welsh. She sings one of the tracks, and I have to say, with her, it was always an ambition to have her on the album, because in my opinion, she is the embodiment of a Shakespearean character alive today. I mean, she could have stepped out of A Midsummer Night's Dream or something. So I always wanted her, also because I met her at the Chateau Marmont in L.A. By the pool. I was with my daughter, who was about 3. At the time, and she saw Florence Welsh walk by the pool, and she went, "Oh my God, it's Ariel from The Little Mermaid," and they ended up playing together. So it started with that, but then the other ones were very, very by chance. You know, whoever was around.
You said you loved working with Florence. We can show a bit of the clip. This is "A Wedding Disgrace," sung by Florence Welsh from Florence and the Machine. Have a listen.
Wedding disgrace with fortune in men's eyes.
Some of the stars on there. We've been having a strange social media conversation with William Shatner
today.
Yes,
I heard.
It's sort of Star Trek against Star Wars. You got Carrie Fisher from Star Wars.
Yeah, no, I'm arguably the only, intermediary available in that dispute. And because I have both Star Trek and Star Wars, or as someone said, shall I compare thee to the Starship Enterprise in one of the articles, I have to be neutral.
Okay.
I'll be the Switzerland of space.
It's difficult to make a choice, isn't it, really, in my view.
You could like them both.
Yeah. And tell us a little bit about this as well, because it's about the fabulous portrayal of you, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a dear friend of mine, Timothy Cummings, painted it. It was actually my husband's idea, Bjorn's, to use him, because he's a great painter. And... I think I'm very brave to have put it out, because I think it's a great painting. I don't know if I look about, I look a little older, I think, right? Or I look a little more theatrical.
Yeah.
So yeah, Taming of the Roo.
Is this a one-off, the Shakespeare album? Obviously for the 400th anniversary, are you going to do something else? Is it inspired you to do something a bit different again?
Yeah, I mean, I would. I mean, look, there's 154 sonnets. Someone actually asked me, oh, you're doing all the sonnets. Yeah, it's an album with 154
tracks. My goodness
tracks.
Me.
No, I would at some point, though I'm now kind of edging closer towards Blake. So you know,
so that
one day
be the
I'll
next
get to
one.
The 21st century. It's my new big, you know, chance for a big radio hit. Go to Blake.
Okay. I love the idea. It's lovely to speak to you. Thank you very
Thank
much
you.
Indeed. And your favorite sonnet is?
Well, I really am a big fan of sonnet number 20. When sonnet number 20, A Woman's Face with Nature's Own Hand Painted.
Nice. Thank you, Rufus. Lovely to see you. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
A new album is called Take All My Love's 9 Shakespeare Sonnets. Thanks, Rufus.
Now, the Queen...